So students, let us learn now third type of construction. So let us see what all information will be given so that we can draw this kind of construction. So the information given will be to construct a triangle if its perimeter, base and the angles which is included, which include the base are given. So here what all things will be given? We have to construct triangle ABC. Such that, so this is just a statement. So let us see what all information will be given in this example. Construct triangle ABC such that AB plus BC plus CA is equal to 11.3 centimeter. So that means what? Perimeter is given. Sum of all the three sides of a triangle is given as 11.3 centimeter. So now in this kind of sum, we don't have base. In every construction, we were at least getting the base of the triangle. Okay. But the other two information is given. Two angles are given. Okay, so as soon as you see this kind of sum, first thing you have to do is you have to look at the points of the two angles. So angle B and angle C should always be at the base. Okay, so if B and C is at the base, that means BC becomes the base of the triangle. Okay, ye trick hamesha yaad rakho. Whenever whichever two angles are given, that you keep it at the base. So these two points will form the one side, that means base of the triangle, and then the remaining point. When B and C is then done, then the remaining point A will go as the third point of the triangle. Okay. So now we don't know exactly where is B, where is C. BC is given? No. AB is given? No. AC is also not given. Only these two angle is given. Angle B is given and angle C is given. So randomly I have drawn this triangle. Suppose ABC is drawn like this. I don't know the measurement. I only know that angle B is 70 degree and angle C is 60 degree. But what information do we have? AB plus BC plus CA is equal to 11.3 centimeter. That means addition of all the three sides, that means perimeter, is given. So how to now crack this kind of construction and get the location of all the three points, let us see. Yahan pe problem kya hota hai, ye construction mein we don't have location of B also, C also and A also, because not even one length is given. इसमें ए बी भी नहीं दिया, बी सी भी नहीं दिया और सी ए भी नहीं दिया, बट द सम ऑफ ऑल द थ्री साइड इज गिवन. ओके, सो फर्स्ट थिंग व्हाट आई हैव टू डू, आई विल ओपन दिस ट्रायंगल व्हिच इज देयर, ए पॉइंट से आई विल ओपन दिस ट्रायंगल. सो दिस लेंथ विल बी देयर, इट विल गो ओवर योर लाइक दिस. ओके, सो एंड दिस लेंथ विल बी देयर सी ए, दैट विल गो ओवर योर लाइक दिस. सो वॉट इट विल लुक लाइक, आई विल ड्रॉ. सो ये जो लेंथ है दैट आई विल टर्न ओवर योर, आई विल ओपन दिस ट्राइंगल. सो ए बी का सेम लेंथ यहाँ पे आ जाएगा एंड इट विल बी, आई विल ड्रॉ लाइक दिस. सो आई एम ओपनिंग द ट्राइंगल. सो ए बी विल बी इक्वल टू दिस लेंथ बिकॉज आई एम ओपनिंग दिस ट्राइंगल. सो दिस लेंथ विल बी सेम एज दिस. यहाँ पे मैं अलग पॉइंट देती हूँ, दैट इज पी. ओके, एंड आई एम, वेन आई एम ओपनिंग दिस ट्राइंगल, आई एम टेकिंग दिस साइड ऑन दैट like down. Okay, so when I take this side down, what will be, I'll just draw that line also. Okay, what it will be, it will be CA will be same as this line, so I'll give two lines over here. Okay, ye jo length hai that will be equal to this length, AB will be equal to PB and CA will be equal to, I'll give this point here as Q, CA will be equal to CQ. ओके, बिकॉज वी हैव ओपन द ट्राइंगल. ये तो पॉइंट है, मैं अभी वहीं पे रखूंगी क्योंकि हम लोग को ए लोकेट करना है, वो एक्चुअल पॉइंट है. बट वेन आई ओपन इट, आई नो दैट ए बी इज सेम एज पी बी एंड सी ए इज सेम एज सी क्यू एंड दिस बेस विल रिमेन एज इट इज. बेस हम लोग जब ओपन करेंगे तो वो वहां पे ही रहेगा. सो नाउ वी कैन से दैट पी बी प्लस बी सी प्लस सी क्यू विल बी इक्वल टू वॉट, इट विल बी सेम एज 11.3 सेंटीमीटर, राइट? बिकॉज ए बी का जो लेंथ है वो सेम पीबी का है, बेस तो सेम रह गया बीसी एंड दिस थर्ड साइड इज, वी हैव टेकन इट ओवर हियर. सो दिस होल लेंथ विल बी दिस लेंथ 11.3 सेंटीमीटर. ओके, सो आई हैव रिटन दैट ओनली ओवर हियर. टेक पॉइंट पी एंड क्यू सच दैट पीबी पीबी इज इक्वल टू एबी एंड क्यूसी क्यूसी विल बी इक्वल टू एसी, दैट मीन्स दिस टू लेंथ्स आर इक्वल. सो नाउ वी कैन राइट डाउन पीबी plus BC, BC is same as this, PB plus BC plus CQ is equal to 11.3 centimeter. Now, ये तीन length का addition is 11.3, थ्री साइड्स ऑफ द ट्रायंगल 11.3 हम लोग ट्रायंगल नहीं बना सकते थे, बट कैन वी ड्रॉ स्ट्रेट लाइन विच इज ऑफ 11.3 सेंटीमीटर? येस वी कैन ड्रॉ बाय यूजिंग स्केल. सो दैट्स व्हाई नाउ दिस वन स्टेप विल बी इजियर. नाउ वंस वी हैव दिस होल लाइन फ्रॉम पी टू क्यू एज 11.3 सेंटीमीटर, स्टिल वी हैव नॉट लोकेटेड दिस थ्री पॉइंट्स. बी एंड सी पॉइंट कहाँ पे रहेगा, ए पॉइंट कहाँ पे रहेगा? सो अभी पी से ए पॉइंट लोकेट हो सकता है, वो कैसे मैं बताती हूँ. पहले ए टू पी पॉइंट यू जॉइन एंड आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इज हैपनिंग. नाउ ऑब्जर्व दिस ओनली ट्रायंगल ए पी बी. इन ट्रायंगल ए पी बी व्हाट कैन यू सी? साइड पी बी इज इक्वल टू साइड ए बी. एंड इन अ ट्रायंगल व्हेन टू साइड्स आर इक्वल दैट ट्रायंगल विल बिकम विच ट्रायंगल? इट विल बिकम आइसोसेलिस ट्रायंगल. सो एंड व्हाट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ आइसोसेलिस ट्रायंगल? कॉन्ग्रुएंट साइड्स opposite angles are also congruent. So PB के opposite angle is which? This angle which I have rounded over here. And AB के opposite is which angle? This angle. So if these two sides are congruent, then these two angles will also be congruent. So I am going to write down over here in triangle APB. You can also write down join point P and A, so that will be clear. In triangle APB, PB is equal to AB. Therefore, triangle APB is an isosceles triangle. And by property of isosceles triangle, or you can say by using isosceles triangle theorem, because that is theorem only. Now write down both this angle, full form likho, BPA, angle BPA will be equal to angle BAP, this angle, these two angles, angle BAP, so middle angle, so P angle P is equal to angle A, okay, by which property? By isosceles angle theorem. Now once we have these two angles equal, we can find out this angle. So अभी A point locate करने के लिए P से अगर ऐसा हम लोग angle एक draw करेंगे तो ये यहाँ पे एक ray चला जाएगा. So we can somewhere on this ray we can locate this point A. तो यहाँ का अगर angle मिल जाएगा, so from P we can keep the protractor and we can plot long ray we can plot, और उसके ऊपर we can locate point A. So that's why we want this angle. So now we can find out this angle. How? So to this angle, triangle APB, this 70 degree angle will become which angle? It becomes exterior angle to these two angles which I have done round. Okay, so ABC becomes the exterior angle to triangle APB. So write down, angle ABC is exterior angle of triangle APB. And by exterior angle property, what do we know? Sum of remote interior angles is equal to the external angle. So angle BPA plus angle BAP is equal to 70 degree. We already know it is 70 degree external angle. But we know BPA is equal to BAP. So can I write down in place of BPA, I'll write down as it is, and in place of BAP, I'll write down again BPA, because both angles are equal from this equation, equation number 1. Okay, so from equation 1, you can write down from equation 1. Okay, so now these two angles are repeating twice, 1 BPA plus 1 BPA is 2 BPA, 2 angle BPA, 70 degree. So now I can get angle BPA. 2 I'll shift on other side, 70 degree divided by 2 is 35 degree. Now I'll immediately plot in this rough figure, this angle I get it as 35 degree. Okay, so once I get this angle, I can draw this ray. Okay, and if I get this angle also from Q, I can draw another ray, and both the rays, wherever they'll coincide, that will be point A. Okay, so let us see. Let us first join point Q. Okay, I'll join this. There is little problem in the space, so please understand, students. I'll have to shift the book a little. All right. So once I draw this, join these two points, what I can do is I have to find out this angle also. So how can I find out this angle? Also in this triangle, and triangle ACQ. What you can see, there are two sides which are equal. AC is equal to CQ. That means this triangle will also become isosceles triangle. And by using isosceles triangle property, I'll get the side which is opposite to CQ. The angle which is opposite to side CQ. That means this angle which I have cross marked. And the angle which is opposite to CA. That means this angle. That will also be equal, because though congruent side ke opposite whatever are the angles, those angles are also congruent. Okay, so now I'll write down in triangle ACQ, AC is equal to CQ. Therefore, directly write down angle CAQ. That means angle A is equal to angle CQA. Angle CQA. By reason, isosceles triangle theorem. Okay. Once we have these two sides angles equal, now we can use external angle property, because we have this angle also. So now angles ACB becomes the external angle to this two remote interior angle of the triangle ACQ. So you can write down angle ACB is exterior angle of triangle ACQ. Okay. Therefore, by using exterior angle property, I'll write down summation of these two angles, angle CAQ and angle CQA, will be equal to what? Will be equal to external angle. So, sum of two remote interior angles is equal to the external angle. So, angle CAQ plus angle CQA is equal to 60 degrees. But CAQ, we have already derived this property. CAQ is same as CQA. So in place of CAQ, I'll write down CQA plus CQA. This I'll put it as it is. Now two times, because it is there, I'll write down two times CQA, which is equal to 60 degree. Now CQA will be equal to 60 upon 2 is 30 degree. Okay. So now I have this angle also, angle CQA as 30 degree. So I have to do only one thing. I'll take the long length PQ as 11.3 centimeter. Then I have this angle 35 degree. So I'll draw a long ray from P as 35 degree angle, and from Q I'll draw a long ray as 30 degree angle. Both the rays, wherever it will meet, that will be point A. We have managed to find point A. But what about point B and point C? That also we don't know. So that we can find out by using the property which we have been studying, that is property of perpendicular bisector. Okay. So now if you observe this triangle, triangle APB, again, what you find out? Length BA is same as length BP. Okay. So whenever two lengths are equal, from this point till the end point of this segment, AX end point hai of segment AP, and B se leke P tak jo length hai, till the other end point of segment AP, both the lengths are equal. That means what? Point B lies on the perpendicular bisector of this segment AP, right? Which we have used in other construction also. So I can draw perpendicular bisector of side AP. Okay, side AP ka perpendicular bisector draw karungi, and that perpendicular bisector will intersect at one point. Okay, and that point will be point B. And similar manner, C ke liye kya karenge? This two length from C till the one end point, of segment AP, the length is equal to this length, that means C to another end point. That means C lies on the perpendicular bisector of which segment? Segment AQ. Okay, so I'll draw perpendicular bisector of segment AQ, and that perpendicular bisector, wherever it will intersect at this segment, that will be point C. Okay, so this is the simplest construction. It might seem little complicated, but it is very simple. You don't have to write all these things again and again when you have to do actual construction. But this is for you all to understand that how do we do the construction. Okay, it is very simple. So now I'm going to do final construction. First, I'm going to draw this whole base PQ as 11.3 centimeter. Okay, so let us do it. So I'll draw PQ as 11.3 centimeter. So from 1 to 11.3, you mark it properly. And stretch a long line. Alright. After that, give this point as P and Q. Okay, now we have to draw 35 degree from point P, right? Ye 35 degree hai. So let us, by using protractor, plot 35 degree angle of point P. So I'll keep it at point P and I'll trace 35 degree. So this is 10, 20, 30, 35 is over here. So I'll stretch a line, long ray you have to stretch, right? To be join karo this and stretch a long line. Yeah. Now from point Q, what is the angle that we have got? Angle Q is 30 degree. So take protractor and plot angle Q. Angle Q as 30, 0, 10, 20, 30. Now join these two points. Now this point is what? I said the intersection point is point A. Now AP ka we have to draw what? Perpendicular bisector, so that perpendicular bisector, wherever it will coincide, that will be point B. So let us do it. I'll take compass, I'll put it on point A first, and I'll take more than half up as well as down. Alright, careful. I'll draw the arc, then I'll put it on point B. I'll cut the arc. Okay, so now I'll join these two points which I have got. After joining these two points, this point, wherever it intersects, that becomes point nothing but point B. Now I'll join point A and point B, because that is the actual triangle. This is the triangle that we want. Okay, now draw here, put your angle 35 degree. Okay, here you can draw like this. Okay, now AQ ka also we have to draw perpendicular bisector. So I'll put it on first point Q and up as well as down. I'll draw the arcs first and then previous arc I'll just intersect. Alright, so once I intersect, I'll join a line between the two points of intersection. Alright, now this point where the perpendicular bisector intersects becomes point C. Okay, this point becomes B. Now you can join point A and C because that is the actual side which we want. Alright, now you can show here these two sides are congruent. This Q angle we took it as 30 degree. Now if you measure angle B, now you will get exactly as 70 degree, as they have showed us in the construction or in the given information, and this angle C will be 60 degree. For cross checking you can check. So this is how we draw the figure. So you can see here the construction is so easy, but here the solving part I showed you, you don't have to do the solving part every time, but I showed you because you can understand how did we get exactly these all points. Okay, these all angles and everything. So now let us do practice set 4.3. So the first sum is, construct triangle PQR in which angle Q is 70 degree, angle R is 80 degree and PQ plus QR plus PR is 9.5 centimeter. Okay, here we have to take two extra points. So let us take two extra points as X and Y. Alright. So which triangle do we want? I will draw a rough figure over here. Randomly I will take any triangle. So we want PQR, right? Always I have said whatever are the angles, you take it at the base. So Q I will take it over here and R I will take it over here. Now which is the remaining point? P. Okay, so Q, what is the angle? It is 70 degree. Put it in the given rough figure. Okay, don't have to get confused. Now what do we have to do? We have to open this triangle and we have to take two points on this side. So I'll take point X. And here I'll take point Y. Alright, now I'll join point X from point P to X and point P to Y. Now we already know because we have opened this triangle, this length is equal to this length and this length is equal to this length. Alright. So now these two angles are going to be equal and these angles are going to be equal. Alright. So by using external angle property, we are going to know that this angle measurement we want so that we can draw this ray. So 70 degree angle ka ye half rahega. So you have to do, always do, when you have to find out this angle, you have to do whatever angle is there over here, uska half karna. So angle PXQ, angle PXQ will be 70 degree upon 2. So how do we get? We add these two remote interior angles is equal to the external angle, and remote interior angles, because they are equal, we write down 2 the same angle, 2 times the same angle PXQ, because both the angles are equal. So 2 yahan pe jo rehta hai, we take it in the denominator. Okay, pehle ka jo construction ka maine jo calculation kiya usme aap prefer kar sakte ho. So always, इतना बड़ा construction करने से अच्छा, you should know that if you want to find out this angle, ये angle का half रहेगा. Okay, 70 divided by 2 you have to do, or any angle over here divided by 2. So now 70 divided by 2 is 35 degree. Again, alright. And when we have to find out this angle, angle PYR, angle PYR, same thing we have to do, this angle 80 degree upon 2 you have to do, so it will be 40 degree. Okay, once we get these two angles, we'll get point P, and ye P point milne ke baad PX ka perpendicular bisector we have to draw, and perpendicular bisector will intersect at point Q, and this side ka will have to draw perpendicular bisector. Okay, so we'll get point R. So let us start. So we have to take P XY is equal to 9.5 centimeter, X to Y. So 9.5 centimeter you take it, 0, say 9.5, right? 9.1 centimeter. So I'll give your XY is 9.5 centimeter. From X, say how much degree we have got? PXQ how much we got. It is 35 degree. It is better if you put it in the figure so that you don't get confused. And PYR we got it as 40 degree. Okay, so immediately from X you plot 35 degree angle, take protractor, and X say 35 degree angle you trace. So 30 and this is 35. Now join this, draw a long ray. And from Y you have to take 40 degree. Okay, so again use protractor. Trace 40 degree angle and join. After you join it, you will get this point as point P. Okay, so from point P to point X, you have to first draw perpendicular bisector. So I'll use compass. I'll put it on point P. I'll take more than half distance and I'll draw the arc. Now I'll put it on point X. I'll cut the arc. Alright. I'll join the two arcs, two intersection points which are there. Join the two intersection point, the point where it intersects on this base, that point becomes point Q. Okay, now PQ tum log join kar sakte because actual triangle is that. Now PY ko also we have to find out the perpendicular bisector so that we get the remaining point which is R. Again use compass, put it on point Y, take more than half, draw arc up as well as down, put it on point P, again draw arc up as well as down. Okay, I'll just, the arc should be, the intersection should be proper so that we'll be able to see two points. Join these two points, one and two, join it. And this point where you get, that is point R. Now you can join point P and point R. Now in actual figure you have not given anything. Okay, so you have to give all the parameters which are mentioned in the rough figure. So this is 35 degree, this is perpendicular bisector, this is 70 degree, this is 80 degree, this is 40 degree. Alright, and this is also perpendicular bisector. And this whole length, you can say it is 9.5 cm. That if you don't want to write down, it is fine. Okay, moving towards next sum. It is construct triangle XYZ. Angle Y is 58 degree. Angle X is 46 degree. And perimeter of triangle is 10.5 cm. So let us draw a rough figure XYZ. Now again you have to first see the triangles. Ye Y and X jo points hai, that you have to take as the base because angle should be at the base. So I'll take X over here and Y over here. Now I'll complete the triangle. And the remaining point X, Y and the remaining point will be Z because triangle is X, Y, Z. Now put angles over here. X will be 46 degree and Y will be 58 degree. Now we have to, what you have to do, you have to open the triangle. So, yahan pe this side will get some length. I'll take the points as L and this length will be equal to this length. Now I have to join these two points and I have to find out this angle. Okay, because this is an isosceles triangle, these two angles become equal. I'll just show it with points. And that's why as soon as these two angles become equal, we use exterior angle property. So 46 degree angle becomes the exterior angle of triangle ZLX. And that's why by using that, we can write down. So I said, whenever you have to find out this angle, ye angle ka half rahega. So ZLX, angle ZLX, matlab angle L, is 46 degree divided by 2. Simple. Wahi karne ka, ye jo external angle rehta hai. So 46 divided by 2 is 2 and 3, 23 degree. Similar manner, ye side open karke hum log yahan pe le lenge. So this side also, we are going to take a point. That point will take it as M. Okay, let us join Z and M. Okay, after joining Z and M, we have to find out this angle also. We know that these two angles are also equal, angle Z and angle M, because these two sides are equal because of the isosceles triangle. So agar ye angle find out karna hai, to external angle ka half rahega. We already know, we have derived that. So angle ZMY will be equal to what? 58 degree upon 2. It will be 2 2s are 4 1 2 9s are 18, so it is 29 degree. So we get angle L as 23 degree and angle M as 29 degree. Okay, so now we can easily plot. After getting these two rays with these angles, we'll get point Z, and then we are going to draw perpendicular bisector. After we draw perpendicular bisector, we'll be able to trace point X and point Y. Okay, on this line. So first take LM is equal to what? Perimeter of a triangle is 10.5 centimeter. So LM is going to be 10.5 centimeter. So let us take that. In fact, I have not mentioned in the previous sum what is the base, because it is always good to mention. So I'll mention it. Your xy kya liya tha? 9.5 cm. So write down in pen only. Xy we have taken as 9.5 cm. It's same as perimeter of the triangle. Okay, as soon as we take your LM is equal to 10.5 centimeter. Let us see what are we going to do. Angle L is what? 23 degree. Let us do that. Angle L, let us take it as 23 degree. Okay. Join now from point M you take 29 degrees. Okay, so I have marked it. I did not have enough space, so I took it on protector and I have marked this point of 29 degree angle. I join the point, and this point that we get is nothing but point Z. Now ZL we have, uska perpendicular bisector when we draw, we'll get point X. Right, so let us take compass and draw perpendicular bisector. So from Z, I'll take more than half and draw up and down. I'll keep it on point L and I'll intersect. Now I'll get 2 points and I'll have to join. So this point which we'll get, intersection on this side LM, that will be point X. Alright, don't forget to mention here 23 degree not Celsius. This is not temperature. So from Z you have to join point X, because this is one side of a triangle, and point M we know it is 29 degree. Now we have to locate point Y, so we have to draw perpendicular bisector of side ZM also. So I'll draw arc, I'll take more than half, I'll draw arc up and down, then I'll put it on point Z, I'll intersect the arc and then I'll join the 2 points of intersection. And this point is Y. We can join point Y and point Z, and here we get a triangle XYZ. Mention here the angles which are given, which you have brought it in the figure. 58 degree, this side is same as this, this side is same as this, this is perpendicular bisector, and rest all things are already mentioned. Okay, so this is how you draw the construction, third construction. It is very easy. So the third sum which is there, that is for the homework, so you draw it properly and don't make any mistakes.